Welcome to the Altico Advisors On Demand series. Today's topic is Day in the Life of a Vice President of Operations Working with Dynamics GP. Today we're going to show you some features and functionalities within Dynamics GP that we've seen our clients use, mainly the Vice President of Operations and other people in the operation areas, to make their lives easier and pull more information out of the system in order to drive business. Some of the key areas of concern we find with people in the operations area are listed on the slide here. Some of the ones I really want to point out, and always number one in any position in any organization that we see, is avoid surprises. And avoid surprises really allows you to focus on your business, avoid interruptions, manage your team better without having to deal with fire drills, and then quite honestly the last bullet is spend some time to devote analysis of your business and making things better as opposed to putting out fires. So these concerns are very consistent across many of our clients. We're going to show you some tools that allow you to deal with these concerns and really drive benefit from a solution well beyond what you've seen today with tools that you know and you've worked with in the past. Just a quick discussion around top traits of performing companies. Aberdeen did a study in September of 2007 looking at mid-market companies and really focused on what are the traits that top performing companies had. And really two come out which are relevant to our discussion today. One is they run a complete process with one application. They avoid dumping things to Excel, setting separate up databases, pulling different applications in. A lot of the processes run through a single application, so everyone has one source of the truth. Second is access to the system by key employees and, more importantly, executives. The old days of writing a report that gets put on the executive's desk or calling him with or her with bookings and different things of the day have kind of ended. Businesses move too fast right now. So these top performing companies were able to get that information out sooner, quicker, and when they want it, not when it gets pushed to them. And basically what Aberdeen has come back and said, these companies, when they're able to put a process within a single system, give access to the key people, they showed increased margin and increased revenue. And everyone, I think, would really like that. So we're going to show you some tools today that really focus on that. Well, why Microsoft Dynamics and why are we talking about that? As one of the owners of Altico, we've chose Dynamics as the tool for us to represent and to deliver to our clients to allow them to better their business. Reality is there's a couple areas where I look at it. One, it's familiar to your people, so your people will be able to get up quicker and faster. Studies show that 50% of any implementation, any deployment of an application is training of your people. It may not be to the consulting firm, it may not be hard dollars, but downtime, lost efficiency, and actual hard dollars out the door will be spent on training. If you have a system that you're familiar with, you're going to be able to get up quicker, you're going to be able to link it into your current infrastructure. The quicker you do that, the more you can really focus on driving productivity and giving key people information, and back to that Aberdeen study, driving more revenue and better margins within your group because people have the information to make decisions timely. Today we're going to look at a few key areas where the vice president of operations, or anyone quite honestly in the operations area, can pull information out of the system. This is not the day-to-day entering of data. We're assuming the data is getting in, and in most systems the data is getting in. But now, how do I get it out? How do I get better use of those pieces? So we're going to look at a couple, and I'll have Jim walk through those. But first is, you arrive in the morning, or potentially remotely come in, or use your phone to understand and get a quick look of shipments from the previous day. Second thing is really get a snapshot of bookings and problem areas. So have we booked business that I don't have enough inventory to deal with? Did we book business for a vendor that I know we're in trouble with? Want to know that information sooner than later. Also, analyze the days in inventory versus lead time is an area that we've seen a lot of our clients. Really understand how much inventory do I have versus how long is it going to take me to get it in or build it in the area of a manufacturer. And what's to run it through production. The last is, a lot of our clients don't get to this last point, but it's how do I analyze the sales? What's going on with my business so I can build a plan going forward and be proactive, able to take benefit of the system and get that information. So I'm going to turn it over to Jim right now to really walk through a few of these points that typically a VP of operations could be using to build out his plan and continue to grow the business.
Thanks, Mike. So as you'll note, I'm actually starting our presentation today with an outlook. A lot of the feedback we get from our clients, which made a lot of sense to us, that everyone does start their day by checking their email. So let's build a set of tools available to them with an outlook to see what's going on within their business. Again, as a role of an operations manager or VP of operations, the key things that we want to look at and provide information to our clients are really starting off with something such as shipments. So I want quick access to know exactly what shipped out yesterday. So I've clicked on the folder here to show me yesterday's shipments. I can look at yesterday. I can look at a different range, specific customers, whatever I want to do. But this allows me now, using a tool called SQL Reporting Services, to view what occurred yesterday from a shipping perspective. So as I click on View Report, what's being brought to the screen here for me is a live shot of a snapshot of information from Dynamics GP, showing me all the items that shipped yesterday, who they shipped to, allowing me to identify any items of concern. I know there were certain orders for a particular customer that we want to make sure went out. It allows our clients to be able to see that information directly from Outlook, never having to log into an application, knowing they're counting on live information. So obviously a key item here for us to be able to see what's going on. Now, moving ahead, if I go back to my inbox, you'll notice a number of emails I have here, in particular the email up top. This is an automatically created email using something called a subscription. So what this allows our clients to do is to push information out to the workplace. I always say there's one version of the truth. If we take a snapshot of what was booked yesterday for orders, send out to the entire organization, when we go and we talk about sales for a given day, a given week, we're talking about the same piece of information. So I'll go now and just open up this Excel spreadsheet. It's like any other Excel spreadsheet I've worked with before. So I can do some analysis with some tools I already know how to use, obviously being Excel. So again, a snapshot from Dynamics GP sent out to our entire user community. I can now go and take a look at this in particular information and do some quick analysis. If I want to go, there's a lot of details here, so I want to kind of go through and find my way through all this and look at some items that I have particular concerns about. I can go ahead and collapse all this information and work my way through. I'll go down here and identify a particular part that I want more information about. As this is an item that's probably typically not sold, I can go through and look at the customer, the order date, the requested ship date, and basically have a few more details of exactly what circumstances surround that particular order. So then I can plan for my given day, my given week, and identify if there's any purchasing that needs to be done, any sort of expediting on the manufacturing side that needs to be done. It really gives me key information to go and do my job better. Now, again, this is any other Excel spreadsheet. If we want to do any sort of highlighting, any sort of graphs, whatever it may be, I work with it like any other Excel spreadsheet. So I'm back in my inbox. Now, there's a number of things obviously available to me here through Outlook, but I also want to focus in on some things that we can do inside of Dynamics GP and some of the flexibility that gives us. So as I switch gears, I'm logging into Dynamics GP and I'm bringing up my homepage. Now, the first thing you'll notice here is that we have metrics up in the top right-hand corner. There are a number of metrics available, over 120 metrics available. A lot of those have to do with operations. So this particular one is showing me my number of late shipments of the past 10 days. And obviously with the tools available to us here, we're making our shipments on time. So there's no late shipments to report within the homepage, which makes me extremely happy. But as I move over here, I'll notice over my reminder section. So this is an example of what we call alerts for our users. So if I look down and I see these items in jeopardy, I'll click on this because this tells me items that are in jeopardy of stockouts. We want to make sure that we have no delays in shipments to our customers, and one of the big problems that some of our clients have had were stockouts. So in response to that, we've built this smart list, allowing them to kind of get visibility to look at inventory on hand compared to the daily usage to determine how many days we have of inventory in stock, and then compare that to our lead time. So anywhere where the lead time is greater than the number of days of inventory that we have in stock, we've put an alert in the system to notify our clients to say, hey, let's take some action. Do we need to go and expedite some orders to the vendors of these particular products? So one of the things I can do is organize different products by different buyers within our organization. Now, with the flexibility of the tool that we're using here, I want to see who that buyer is. So I'm just going to add that column quickly to this particular smart list to identify who the buyer is with my organization. So I'll just click on columns, click on add. And as I look at this list of fields available about items, about their quantities, this is all in business terms. So I don't have to know database structure, anything to that effect. I don't have to know the different field names. I just know that I want buyer ID. So I'll go and I'll click on buyer, hit OK. I'm actually going to move that to the top of our list. Hit OK now, and all the buyers identified in my smart list. So I know in this example that Terry Adams is the buyer for these particular parts. I can contact Terry quickly and understand what's going on with these particular products.
Jim, that's a great feature. I'm curious, is that what we do with our clients, or do our clients able to do that with the smart list builder?
So that's a great question, Mike. So this tool is designed by Microsoft for users to be able to build it on their own. So we will work with our clients to build a set of smart lists, but what we see is this is where really clients tailor the system for their own needs and do this on their own. So the whole idea behind the tool is to allow users to build these queries on their own. So we do see that from a number of our clients, that they are able to build these.
That's great. What a great tool.
So shifting back to Outlook, there's another set of tools just to let folks look at the data and do some analysis. So what I'm actually going to do is bring up an Excel spreadsheet. And unlike how I've typically seen clients use Excel in the past, what we're able to do now is actually use Microsoft Excel as truly as a BI tool. Excel in this example is connected directly to the database. So instead of dumping out data, manipulating it, doing charts and graphs, etc., I'm actually reading Dynamics GP in real time through Excel. Now, if we look at this particular chart, I'm looking at sales by product by year. This is a tool that we did build for one of our clients. And what it allows them to do is to say, I want to do additional analysis on the sales. I want to build one set of the truth and allow different people to take different angles at that particular data. The buzzword used is 360 degree view of information. So again, starting off with sales by product, family by year, I can now manipulate this to really give me the analysis I'm looking to perform. So instead of product family, perhaps, I want to figure out who's buying. Who's buying from us? What customers are really have a lot of activity? So I'm gonna pull product family out and bring in customer. So now this analysis is by my customers, by year, identifying who's really purchasing from us. Perhaps bringing back in product family now makes some sense. So I want to do some additional analysis on what they're buying. So I can bring back in product family. And if I want to see exactly what they're buying beneath that, I can bring in my item descriptions. So it really gives me some flexibility. I started off with a report that just showed me product family. I then looked at it strictly by customer. Then I looked at by customer, by product family, by particular parts. Now, the other thing from an operations perspective, sales dollars are great, but I also want to look at quantities. So perhaps I'm going to take my sales price out and bring in quantities so I understand how many units are being purchased by our customers. So I'll drag that in, and the analysis now is looking at quantities. The key here is that everybody within our organization is looking at one set of data, one version of the truth. We're all just looking at it from different angles, allowing us to do analysis on the same piece of information.
Okay, Jim, that was great. Some really good information. But just to summarize it, we looked at the operations manager, or really a lot of our clients is really where we're looking at it from, came in, was able to, through a tool called SQL Reporting Services, understand the previous day shipments, understand if there was any short shipments, understand anything, any problems or any expectations were there, but get that right away in the morning, not have to ask people, not have to look for reports, not have to have a special report written. It was actually delivered right to the inbox. Second was, you know, get a snapshot of the booking. Same thing. I open my email. The report that I want is sitting there waiting for me. I can understand what booked. what I'm going to have to fulfill, when the expected ship dates are. Any information I need, I can get, and also could be shared with my team. So we see a lot of clients using that tool, a report like that, to really make decisions. It's not just a bunch of data that you have to pull out. Tell me the data I want and have it sent to me every day so I know to work with it. It's very interesting because our clients end up using that and it becomes something that they just can't live without, and for years they never had it. Then analyzing the day's inventory was with a tool called Smart List Builder, and you're able to look at a field, like Jim was able to add the buyer, could potentially forward that out to the buyer, share that information with them, and really understand what things are we going to be short on and how do we deal with them. Better to deal with them now than later. And then the last piece was, since everything was really in decent shape, shipments were on time as according to the home screen and GP, I was able to spend some time, and Jim spent some time analyzing the sales. I was able to play with it in Excel, a tool that he knows, and most of our clients know. Play with the numbers, look at it different ways, by dollars, by customer, by product, family, by units, all really to understand where the business is going. So some exciting stuff that we see our clients, especially in the operation areas, using these tools. I'm sure you can think of other applications with these tools or other areas, but again, using tools that you know, Excel, Outlook, to get the information, move it around, and forget about learning an application, more about focusing on your business. So thank you for spending a couple minutes with Altico Advisors on our on-demand series. And really, if you have any questions, feel free to visit our website or give us a call. Hopefully this was beneficial and you grabbed some information, and hopefully we can help you make your life a little easier in your day-to-day job.